Read again. One of the most difficult things we ever have to face in this life is when the love we show others is not returned. Right? I'm sure you know exactly what I'm talking about. Now, sometimes it happens between spouses. One gives and gives and gives, and the other takes and takes and takes some more. It happens with our friends sometimes as well. Those times when we find ourselves willing and eager to do just about anything for someone we care about, but they, unfortunately, often are not there for us when we need them the most. And mothers and fathers occasionally experience the same sort of thing with their daughters and sons, especially as they grow into adulthood. And of course, the opposite can also be true and just as disappointing. Now sadly, we don't always receive the same level of kindness we show to those we love the most. There are even times when those we have been given good, those we have been given good to, turn around and cause us great pain and sorrow. And even sometimes as simple as occasionally not receiving a thank you when we give a couple of dollars to a homeless person or someone else in need can make us feel a little hurt inside. Now, simply put, when we show others love, we'd like for them to show us a little love in return. That just seems to be a normal part of our human fallen experience. Now today, we gather as a people of faith to remember and to give thanks for a perfect act of love, a gift of God in the person of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, laying down His life for us. It's really almost impossible for us to comprehend. No other faith that we know of makes such a claim. Our God loves us so much that He is willing to do anything and go anywhere for us here and today. No exceptions and no qualifications. God loves us more than we could ever love our own selves. And as we contemplate this great mystery, our hearts are filled with a tremendous amount of gratitude, grateful for the gift of Jesus pouring out His very life on our behalf. We love it when we are loved that, don't we? Yet that's not what's happening here. Nothing of that sort. In fact, like much of what we believe in faith, it's quite the opposite from what we might imagine. God, our Heavenly Father, did not send His Son because we loved Him. Jesus didn't climb on Calvary because we loved Him. No matter how hard it is for us to understand or believe, God doesn't love us because we love Him. He loves us first, unconditionally and completely. When we disobey, God loves us anyway. And when we wander away from Him, He loves us anyway. And when we ignore His voice and place our will above His, He loves us anyway. And that's just how He is. God is love. That's an incredible God who created us and sustains us in our very being each and every day. That's the God who revealed to us through our Lord Jesus Christ, the God who carried His cross so that we might have life. And for this, we simply give thanks. And while that fills our hearts with gratitude and hope, as it should, it is also present, it presents us with a challenge this day. For if we believe that love should be returned with love, then that puts us on notice. If we truly believe that God has loved us first, then we must ask ourselves some very important questions. Will we, as His disciples, respond to His selflessness with selfless acts of our own? Will we carry our own crosses for our sake and for the sake of others, knowing that He has carried His cross for the salvation of the world? Will we forgive those who have wronged us, knowing that our Lord and Savior died for the forgiveness of sins? Do we have the courage and willingness to love all people in every situation? thereby responding in faith to the one who has loved us first. My dear brothers and sisters, in a few moments, we will venerate the cross, a symbol of hope and a symbol of God's great love for us. And by doing so, we are showing a profound sense of gratitude for all the Lord has done for us and continues to do for each and every one of us, each and every day. But let's not let that be the only way we show how much Jesus means to us. Let's be sure to take the love he poured out for our sake and pour out that same love on those around us. God loves us more than we can ever imagine. Of that we can be certain. May we never take that love for granted. Instead, let's make sure it gets returned. Imperfectly at times, I'm sure, but returned nonetheless. And may God fill each of your hearts with true gratitude.